these two guys played a hilarious prank on McDonald's. Everyone's followed that French fry smell into a McDonald's at least once, probably more than that. Heck, some of you might have ordered a Big Mac in another country. All that said, how often do you really look around at your local McDonald's? When two avid fast food fans visited their local Pearland, Texas chain, they noticed something pretty unusual about the decor. This was when they came up with a plan to change their local McDonald's and hopefully make a point in the process. Did you ever notice the decor at your local McDonald's? Let us know in the comments section below. And then be sure to leave us a like and hit subscribe for more. Jeff Maravella, a 20-year-old student at the University of Houston, is a real funny guy with his own YouTube channel called Jevolution. His friend, Christian Toledo, is a 24-year-old Goodwill ambassador. Jeff and Christian often frequented the local McDonald's in Pearland. And while eating out together on one occasion, they noticed something funny about the area where they enjoyed their tasty fried meal. As they sat at their table along a wall at McDonald's, they noticed that there were posters hanging in each dining area except for theirs. They began looking at all the posters and decor and noticed something particular about them. They noticed that all the models in the photos were smiling and happy, and that they were a diverse group of men, women, and children. Still, Jeff and Christian noted that no Asians were represented in any of the photos. Jeff said on his YouTube channel, "If you haven't noticed, there aren't a lot of Asians represented in the media. There are literally no Asians on any of these walls. Maybe we can change that." The pair realized what they had to do. Being that Jeff and Christian were of Asian descent and proud of it, they wanted to play a small, harmless prank and see if anyone would notice. Little did they know the wild ride making such a harmless decision would take them on. The two made their own poster to hang in the bare space that was next to their table at the Pearland, Texas McDonald's. They grabbed Jeff's camera and tripod and got to work. They purchased some McDonald's food to make their planned photo look authentic and shot outside a local event center. They had previously studied the pre-existing wall posters to ensure that their photo, featuring themselves, would look authentic. That same night, they uploaded their winning photo and began to edit it. They even added the McDonald's logo in the bottom right corner and some detail for dimension and legitimacy. The last thing to do was have their canvas poster printed through Office Depot. It only took about a week to be delivered, and Jeff and Christian were so impressed with how realistic it turned out. They showed some of their friends and Jeff's mother, who did not approve of the prank at first, but eventually realized how funny and harmless it was. The next plan of action was to figure out how they were going to get the poster into the McDonald's and successfully hang it on the wall without anyone or any employee noticing. This was when Christian had a brilliant idea. They went to Goodwill to see if they could find a McDonald's employee shirt for Jeff to wear. Out of pure luck, they found an old McDonald's shirt, and it was Jeff's size too. All the pieces of their prank were falling into place. The day had come for them to hang up their poster. Jeff got dressed in his employee shirt, a walkie-talkie, black tie, and name badge that read Jeff Bergara, Regional Interior Coordinator. Christian and a friend, Cassandra, accompanied Jeff to help with the placement of the poster. They walked into the McDonald's and no one thought anything about them being there. They made sure to use adhesive backing so they wouldn't damage the wall when and if the poster needed to be taken down. And after all this planning, the poster was finally hanging in the Pearland, Texas McDonald's. Now all they had to do was wait. They kept a low profile when visiting their local McDonald's, but it didn't seem to matter because it appeared that no one even noticed the poster was up. It hung there for 51 days before Jeff took it one step further. He took to Twitter to share the photo of him and Christian posing in front of the poster, stating, "I noticed there was a blank wall at McDonald's, so I decided to make this fake poster of me and my friend. It's now been 51 days since I hung it up." The tweet went viral, with more than 1 million likes and 260,000 retweets. It got so popular that TV host Ellen DeGeneres saw it and invited Jeff and Christian to be on her show. That's not where their viral fame ended, though. Ellen explained how McDonald's actually loved what the boys had done. The company announced it would use the two of them in a real marketing campaign. Ellen continued to explain that McDonald's would pay them for their hard work and brought out two $25,000 checks for each of the boys. McDonald's later retweeted, "You guys earned this dream. Looking forward to more work from the best regional interior coordinators we've ever met." They also explained that due to a previous renovation plan, the poster and all the posters in the chain would be taken down. but they auctioned off the poster and donated the proceeds to the Ronald McDonald House Houston Children's Charity. Jeff and Christian were blown away by how their prank went viral and ultimately started a conversation revolving around Asians in the media. As Jeff said in an interview, "We all deserve equality, and all races deserve recognition." What do you think about Jeff and Christian's prank? Let us know in the comments section below. And then don't forget to leave this story a like and subscribe for more.